Hi friends, welcome to Study Cloud. Today's topic is why India is unhappy and which factors affect India's happiness. Lot to know, lot to discuss. Before we begin the topic, if you're new to our channel, then please subscribe and watch complete video.
India has been ranked 139 out of 149 countries in the list of UN World Happiness Report 2021 released in last month. The World Happiness Report 2021, issued by the UN Sustainable Development Solutions Network, focuses on the effects of COVID-19 and how people all over the world have fared. It ranks the world's 149 countries on how happy their citizens perceive themselves to be. Their aim was twofold: first, to focus on the effects of COVID-19 on the structure and quality of people's lives, and second, to describe and evaluate how governments all over the world have dealt with the pandemic. World Happiness Report 2021, the ninth iteration of this publication, was released on the 20th of March, observed as the UN International Day of Happiness. The picture about India's happiness quotient presented by this report is quite disappointing. Therefore, it is imperative to take a deep dive into the insights provided by this publication to understand the reasons for a largely unhappy India. The WHR ranks happiness on the basis on what are referred to as life evaluations. Cantrell ladder measures the quality of life. The highest quality of life corresponds to standing on top of the ladder with score of 10, while the worst quality of life is equivalent to being on the bottom of the ladder with a score of 0. Respondents that score 7 or more on the Cantrell ladder are classified as thriving in terms of their quality of life. Those scoring between 4 and 7 are said to be struggling, while those who score 4 and below are termed as suffering. Parameters include household income, health, generosity demonstrated by citizens, freedom to make life choices, perceptions about corruption, social support by friends and relatives enjoyed by citizens, education, employment, age, gender, marital status, and trust in institutions. Why India is not unhappy? There are some reasons to solve this question. Let's see. First one, declining income and employment. The year 2020 is a testimony to how an unprecedented humanitarian crisis in the form of the COVID-19 pandemic wreaked havoc around the world. One of the immediate responses to the onset of this crisis was the imposition of a lockdown in many countries. India was one of them. This lockdown dealt a severe blow to the Indian economy. The most severe repercussion of this lockdown manifested as the migrant crisis in the country. Loss of livelihoods and a consequent decline in incomes were inevitable. Of course, consistent with the timing and relative stringency of the lockdown, the steepest decline in incomes were witnessed in April 2020, of 19% and 41% in rural and urban India respectively. This decline corresponds to an economic degrowth of 23% and an unemployment rate of around 24%. On the Corruption Perceptions Index 2020, India scores 40 on 100. Scores in between 90 to 100 represent a very clean nation, while a score in the range 0 to 9 represents a highly corrupt nation. India ranks 86 among 180 nations on CPI 2020. There are experts who believe that the score fails to capture the true greater extent of corruption in India. Echoing this belief are the findings of the survey called the Global Corruption Barometer Asia, published by Transparency International. According to this survey, India has the highest overall bribery rate, 39%, and the highest rate of citizens using personal connections, 46%, in Asia. To quote the findings of the report, of the people surveyed in India who came into contact with the police, 42% had paid bribes. The use of bribes was also rampant, 41%, to obtain official documents such as identity papers. Use of personal connections was also largely made in dealings with the police, 39%, procurement of identity documents, 42%, and in relation to courts, 38%. Next one, lack of social support. National scores on social support are either 0 or 1. India attained a score of 0.617, higher only to the scores of 3 countries out of the total 95 nations for which data was collected in the 2020 survey. In other words, as far as social support is concerned, India ranks as low as 92 among 95 nations for which data were available. Next one, age composition of India's population. India's demography is predominantly young. About 67% of India is in the age group 15 to 64 years. The WHR 2021 informs us that there has been a significant reduction in the frequency of reported health problems from 23% to 20% for the population as a whole, while such increments being more pronounced among those above the age of 60. As far as India is concerned, these gains went to a minority of the population thanks to its youth-dominated structure. Furthermore, life evaluations are considerably higher among those below the age of 30 and above the age of 60. Roughly 50% of the population lies in these age intervals. Gains in life evaluations enjoyed by this half of the population might have very well been offset by the worry, anger, and sadness experienced by the loss of livelihoods and income experienced by the remainder half of the population. As already argued, the burden of these losses was heavier in the Indian context. What was once celebrated as an opportunity to reap demographic dividends has now turned into a national liability given the unemployment levels in the country.
These are the some reasons that affects India's happiness. If you want to read more on this topic, then read article given on official website of ORF. If you like the video, then please do subscribe and share with your friends. Stay tuned with us and thank you for watching, and see you in next video.